We're following breaking news out of Minneapolis tonight. Within just the last 5 minutes, the city of Minneapolis announced Betsy Hodges just won the mayoral election. Her final vote total is just under 39,000. Second place, Mark Andrew, finished just under 25,000 votes. And after more than 50 hours of counting those votes, city officials and election advocates are looking for changes that could make the next vote go a little more quickly. Fair Vote Minnesota says that this election went well because it was fair and it was accurate, but they add that it could have been faster. Fair Vote's executive director, Gene Massey, says that while the blueprint is good, it may have been overwhelmed.
The delay and the hiccup is being created because of the number of candidates in the race. I think the city did not see that coming when the ordinance was written, and they didn't see it coming when they didn't change the filing requirement.
And the four suggestions from Fair Vote include raise the requirements for filing, add more ranks from three choices to maybe five, allow for candidates with no votes or low vote totals to be removed from the count entirely, and automate, although the city says that it can't automate because no one makes the equipment. Well, let's turn again to David Schultz. We want to talk about some of those possible changes and what they could mean for the system. Let's start with the idea of picking more than just your top three candidates, maybe your top five candidates.
Yeah, that's actually one very good idea, because one of the concerns that we have right now with the ranked choice voting is we have over 3,000 expired votes. And what do we mean by that is individuals who ranked three people but who didn't make it into sort of like the upper cut at this point. And in some ways, their votes aren't going to be counted now, or at least not for the final. And so I think that's one very good suggestion in terms of getting voters a greater option. Now, the one downside of that is you have to study a few more candidates.
Yes. Let's talk about the idea, though, of all the candidates. We have 35 candidates. It was very clear early on that most of these candidates weren't going to win. If there were some way to just eliminate the candidates who was clear weren't going to win, that would probably move the whole process along faster, wouldn't it?
Exactly. We knew on election night, for example, that you could probably estimate of the 35 candidates, probably 30 of them had no mathematical chance of winning, period. Just they couldn't win no matter what at that point. Had we automatically on Tuesday, or actually Wednesday, I'm sorry, on Wednesday, said, okay, those bottom 30 are going to be eliminated and they're going to be moved over in terms of their second or third choices for the voters, we would probably have an answer by late Wednesday afternoon. And so that's a change in procedure that the city really should implement.
Thank you, David. And